We're at the LSA Expo at Front Range Airport in Denver, Colorado.
I think this is the second year that they put this on.
This is the second year. This is our first year here.
Now, what is it that you do? I guess you're into light sport, but what's it
like? Yes, we're actually a large Part 141 flight school. We're the largest flight school in Colorado. We're also the only Part 141 school in the Denver area. We do training in Cessna aircraft from 172s, 182s, 172RGs, Piper Turbo Seminoles, and then, of course, the Skycatcher.
Now, the Skycatcher has just been out now. I guess they've been producing them for 3 or 4 years now, but they're just starting to get them out onto the market now?
Yes, sir. There was a little bit of a delay from Cessna. It took them a few years to get the airplane through its initial certification tests, and they were a little slow on their initial deliveries, but now they're going full throttle with the aircraft.
Yeah, I understand. Last year, they were actually the lead in as far as the new registrations on the registration list.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
What are some of the things about the Skycatcher that make it stand out from the crowd?
Well, the Skycatcher is the only light sport aircraft that's built by a mainline manufacturer. You know, Cessna Aircraft is the most reputable aircraft manufacturer in the world, especially when it comes to light airplanes and flight training. So that makes the Skycatcher stand out quite a bit. Also, you have to consider that the Skycatcher, unlike a lot of light sport aircraft, has a Continental O200 engine, which again is a very reputable engine made by a very reputable manufacturer. It's not a Rotax. So you get the Continental name, you get a lot more reliability with that engine. You know, it's an excellent airplane. Performance is another thing that makes this airplane stand out. Power to weight ratio on this airplane is actually better than a 172. So despite the fact that it only has a 100 horsepower engine, you can expect very good initial short field takeoff, climb performance, short field landing performance from this airplane. It's Continental O200 engine, as I said, 100 horsepower, which gives this airplane 12.2 pounds per horsepower, which is a lot better than a 172, which is about 14 pounds per horsepower.
Now, are you using the airplane in a training environment now?
Absolutely. We've been one of the fuel schools that have been able to successfully market the Skycatcher. We've done several certifications. We've done a lot of first solos. And the airplane's very popular for time building as far as cross countries and things like this. So not only do we train a lot of sport pilots in this airplane, but a lot of our commercial pilot applicants use the airplane for those purposes as well.
Now, are you finding a lot of your students are starting to learn in this airplane and then moving up, or are they staying into the light sport field?
Absolutely. In fact, we just recently did a transition from sport to private. And it is a popular transition because we can get a sport pilot certificate realistically for around $3,995, whereas an initial private costs around $7,995. But of course, a person can transition very easily from a sport to a private. So if people are, you know, not 100% sure about what their future is going to be in aviation, they want to start with the sport pilot, this is an excellent option for them. And we have done those transitions before.
Now, if someone were to walk into you and they really don't have any flight experience, but they have that little bug that they want to get into flying, how long would it actually take them to get to learn how to fly?
Well, it depends on how deeply the person wants to get into flight training. We offer discovery flights for $99 where a person can simply go up and fly the airplane. That's one of our main selling points, is get the people in the air and then let the love of flying sell itself. Now, was your question about specifically how long does it take to...
For example, myself, I can walk into your school and I've never flown before and I would really like to learn how to fly. How long is it going to take me to get through that process?
Very good. We actually offer an accelerated program. We can do a sport or a pilot in as little as 30 days. We'll fly with you every day. We have an instructor that can schedule with you every day. Our school is open 24/7, 365 days a year, and we offer flight training at all of those times. So we can do it very efficiently. But of course, it's according to your own schedule, so it can take you as long as a year if that's what you have in your budget and your time frame and things like this. The typical completion time for a sport pilot is 3 months. It's 4 months for a private. But as I said, we offer accelerated programs as well.
Now, what is the ground school and so on and so forth involved in this as well?
Yes. As a Part 141 flight school, we offer a ground school that's coupled directly with our flight training programs. You have a multimedia ground school that you perform on your own, and of course it's supplemented by your instructor. But ground school lesson one corresponds directly with flight lesson one. So it's an integrated flight training approach that Cessna and King schools offer. Keep in mind that as a Part 141 flight school, there is no Part 141 sport pilot, but we still use the same King schools training program to correlate with that.
So if somebody wanted to get more information or get in contact, do you have a website or something to get hold of?
Absolutely. It's www.flights-inc.com. You can also contact us by phone at 303-799-5140.
Thank you very much for your time.
All right, thank you.